Hello friends, I am Amarnath. Today we will discuss some of the questions taken from India Yearbook which are helpful for UPSC preliminary exam which is to be conducted in the year 2020. The first part of in the four part series. Right? So let us start paper discussion. You take the first question, consider the following about Deccan rivers. The Deccan rivers are rainfed and therefore fluctuate in volume. Many of these are non-perennial, they are short in length and have a limited catchment areas. So which of the statements are correct? Right? So here below the question you can find the explanation at which is directly taken from India Yearbook. So if you take this explanation, the Deccan rivers are rain fed, they are rain fed and therefore fluctuate in volume. So coming to the first statement, it is correct. The Deccan rivers are rain fed and therefore fluctuate in volume. Right? Many of them are non-perennial. So, this is what the second line. They are short in length and have a limited catchment areas. The coastal streams, especially on the west coast, are short in length and have a limited catchment areas. So it means not all the Deccan rivers have a short catchment area. So it is only the west flowing rivers or the coastal streams, right, which are short in length, have a limited catchment area. So that means this third statement is wrong because this statement is only applicable for those streams which are seen in coastal regions, particularly in the west coast, but not of all the Deccan rivers. So that is the reason why the answer is 1 and 2. Coming to second question, the Himalayan states being more temperate experience two additional seasons, autumn and spring. Right? The northeast monsoons commonly known as winter monsoons blows from land to sea, whereas southwest monsoons known as summer monsoons blow from sea to land. So which of them is true? Right? So here the Himalayan states experience two additional seasons because of their temperate regions. Now whether it is true or false. Himalayan states being temperate experience two additional seasons, that is autumn and summer. Traditionally, Indians note six seasons, each about 2 months long. These are the following seasons and they are based upon astronomical divisions of the 12 months into six parts. That is, all these seasons are of 2 months, right? And the entire year is divided into 6 months. The ancient Hindu calendar also reflects the same seasons. Right? So this is what about the first statement. So first statement is correct. Coming to the second one, northeast monsoons commonly known as winter monsoons, whereas southwest monsoons commonly known as summer monsoons. So here the issue is how this monsoon blows. So during northeast monsoons, right, commonly known as winter monsoons, winds blows from land to sea, whereas southwest monsoons known as summer monsoons, they blow from sea to land after crossing the Indian Ocean, Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal. And we know that most of the monsoon brings the rainfall during the it is the southwest monsoons which brings most of the rainfall to India. So coming to our question, which of the above is true? So both are true. Coming to third question, the principal tributaries of Brahmaputra in India are Subansiri, Jaibareli, Dhansiri, Putimahari. Right? So answer is all the above. So you can find all the principal tributaries of Brahmaputra. So remember, these questions are taken from the first chapter of India Yearbook, that is Land and People. It is Land and People from where these questions are taken, right? And the explanation is a direct, it is directly taken from India Yearbook also. Coming to fourth question, the flora of country is being studied by Botanical Survey of India. The ethnobotanical study deals with utilization of plants and plant products by ethnic races. The Himalayan region, the Himalayan botanical region extends from Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh, passing through Sikkim. Which of the above statements is correct? So let me talk about this. The flora of the country being studied by Botanical Survey of India, and its 9 circles, field offices located all over the India. So the first statement is yes, it is correct. Right? Even this question is taken from the first chapter, that is land and people. Right? Botanical study deals with utilization of plants and plant products by ethnic races, right? So this a scientific study of such plants is done by Botanical Survey of India, right? And if you take this third statement, the entire Himalayan region, it extends from Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh, passing through all the Himalayan states including Sikkim, right? So answer is all the above. So all the above is the answer. Coming to fifth question, as per the provisions of Flag Code of India 2002, there are restrictions on the display of national flag by members of general public, private organizations, educational institutions, etc. Coming to second statement, right? Apart from non-statutory instructions issued by government from time to time, right, display of national flag is governed by the provisions of the emblems and names, that is improper prevention of improper use of emblems and names and prevention of insults to National Honor Act 1971, right? So let us examine this code. So this question is taken from the topic of polity, national emblem, right? So apart from, coming to first statement, right, as per the provisions of Flag Code of India 2002, there are restrictions on the display of national flag by members of general public, right? So if take this, the Flag Code of India 2002, effective from 26 January 2002, superseded the Flag Code of India as it existed then, right? So as per this provisions of Flag Code of India 2002, there is no more restriction. There is no restriction on the display of national flag by the members of general public, private organizations, educational institutions, except to the extent provided by the Emblems and Names Act 1950. Right? So if you take this first statement is wrong. So this is a wrong statement. Whereas coming to second statement, apart from the non-statutory instructions issued by the government from time to time, the display of national flag is governed by the provisions of the Emblems and Names Act 1950 and Prevention of Insults to National Honor Act 1970. Right? The Flag Code is an attempt to bring all such laws, conventions, right, and practices for the guidance of all the concerned. Right? So, first statement is wrong, whereas second statement is correct. Right? So this is what about the question is. Coming to sixth question, all the provisions of constitution as amended from time to time have become applicable to the existing Jammu Kashmir with effect from August 5th 2019, right? So once again I'll read the question. All the provisions of the constitution as amended from time to time have become applicable to the existing Jammu and Kashmir with effect from August 5th 2019, right? So after repealing Article 370 of the constitution, right? So all those provisions of the constitution which are amended from time to time, they are applicable to the existing Jammu Kashmir, that is Jammu Kashmir after repealing of Article 370. Existing Jammu Kashmir with effect from August 5th, 2019. Yes, this is correct, right? So the Citizenship Act, so the first paragraph, answers this question, right? Coming to second question, coming to second statement, the Citizenship Act was amended by Citizenship Amendment Bill 2019 is applicable to all the states and union territories. That is, the Citizenship Act 2019, it is applicable to all the states and union territories. So this is what the statement says. So let us examine the statement. Really, it is applicable to all the states or not? So if you take the second this paragraph, right, the provisions of the act does not apply to tribal areas of Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Tripura, right, as included in 6th schedule of the constitution. That means this act is not applicable to tribal areas, as mentioned in 6th schedule, right, and those areas where there is the Inner Line Permit Act is applicable to the states of Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Mizoram and Manipur, right? So that means this word of all the states and union territories, right, it is applicable to all the states and union territories, whether it is true or false, right? So though it is applicable to all the states and union territories, there are exemptions to certain areas, that is those areas which are mentioned in 6th schedule of the constitution, as well as those areas where there is implementation of the inner line permit, right? So the answer for this question is both 1 and 2. The answer for this question is both 1 and 2, right? It is applicable to all the states. It doesn't mean that Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram and Tripura are exempted. Though they are applicable to all the states, there is an exemption to these tribal areas. So make this point very clear, right? It is applicable to all the states and UTs, right, with these exemptions. This is what about the second, sixth question. Coming to seventh question, the general purpose, consider the following statements. General purpose committee considers and advises speaker or chairman on matters concerning affairs of the house which do not appropriately fall within the purview of any parliamentary committee, right? Delegated legislation is subjected to review and control by parliament, right? So general public committee considers and advises which do not fall in the purview of any parliamentary committee. Yes, so this is taken from the topic of parliamentary committees, right? So any issue which is not within the ambit of any parliamentary committee will be taken up by this general purpose committee, right? So this committee advises the speaker or the chairman in, right, on the matters concerning the affairs of the house. And coming to the second statement, so first statement is correct, whereas second statement, delegated legislation is always subjected to review and control by parliament. So we have a separate committee called as Committee on Subordinate Legislation. It is this Committee on Subordinate Legislations which scrutinizes and reports. It is this Committee on Subordinate Legislations which scrutinizes and reports to the House whether the power to make rules, laws conferred by the Constitution or by the law of Parliament. So it is this committee which scrutinizes all the delegated legislations. So this is a way of exercising parliamentary control over delegated legislation. So answer is both 1 and 2. Which of the following are departments under Home Ministry? So in the right, you have given all the departments which are working within the Home Ministry, right? So Minister, Department of Internal Security, States, Official Language, Home, right? Department of Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh Affairs, Department of Border Management. Now Internal Security, States, Official Language, but we don't have any separate Department of Population. So answer is only 1, 2 and 3. Consider the following statements about public grievances. The Directorate of Public Grievances was set up in the Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances. Grievances can be lodged with DPG through post, email or by lodging the complaint online on the portal. Right? The Central Public Grievances Redressal and Administrative Reforms Committee, right? The PGRAMS, the operating system of grievance redressal portal covering all the ministries of Government of India. So PGRAMS is the operating system for public grievances portal, right? So whether this is true or false, so let us see. The Directorate of Public Grievances was set up in Cabinet Secretariat. It is set up in Cabinet Secretariat, but not in the Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances. So this is wrong. Right? So next, grievances can be lodged with DPG through post, email, or through online. Right? So the cases received offline are entered in the system, and thereafter all the cases are handled using PGRAMS application. Right? So PGRAMS is the operating system for the operating system for handling all the public grievances. So all those grievances which are received offline, they are handled by using this PGRAMS application. So one is wrong and two and three are the correct answer. So this is the answer. Coming to 10th question, consider the following. The United Nations Department of Economic and Social Affairs brings out the UN e-government survey every 2 years, which provides an analysis for the progress in using e-government. For providing analysis of progress in using e-government. This is one first statement. Coming to second statement, the Department of Electronics and Telecommunications is the administrative ministry for ensuring e-office implementation. E-office aims to increase the usage of workflow and rule-based file routing, quick research and retrieval of files and office order. Alright, so let me talk answer for this. So here, the United Nations Department, that is UNDESC, that is UNDESA, United Nations Department of Economic and Social Affairs, brings out UN e-government survey every 2 years. That is, once in 2 years, this report is brought out by UN body, UN Department of Economic and Social Affairs. So statement one is correct. It is correct. E-Office is one of the important mission mode projects for implementing Digital India Plan, right? So the Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievance is the administrative ministry for ensuring e-office, right? So if you take the second statement, the Department of Electronics and Telecommunications, right? So here, make sure it is this department of DAR and PG, which handles, right, which ensures e-office implementation. So this statement is wrong. E-office aims to increase the usage of workflow and rule-based file routing, quick research and retrieval of files and office order. So this is what the start answer is. So third statement is a correct statement, right? So if take this answer is 1 and 3 is the answer. Coming to 11th question, global learning and observation to benefit the environment is a hands-on international environmental science and education program. So GLOBE, shortly called as GLOBE, is a hands-on international environmental science and education program. Ministry of Environment and Forest is implementing agency for GLOBE in India. So let us see this. So GLOBE is an international environmental science and education program that brings students, teachers, scientists together to study the global environment. So Ministry of Environment Forests and US government signed an agreement in 2001 to implement the GLOBE program in India. So it is both the Ministry of Environment Forests and the US government has signed. Right? So Indian Environmental Society is the implementing agency for GLOBE in India, though an agreement was signed between the government of India as well as the government of US, right? It is this institution, Indian Environmental Society, which is based in Delhi, is the implementing agency for GLOBE in India. So Ministry of Environment Forest is the implementing agency. So this is wrong. Second statement is wrong, right? So it is only one which is correct. The answer is only one. Consider the following. National Adaptation Fund for Climate Change is a central sector with NABARD as national implementing entity. Right? National Nature Campaign Program is an initiative of Ministry of Environment Education, which is aimed at creating greater awareness, understanding and empathy of children with and for the environment. Right? So National Adaptation Fund for Climate Change, right, is a central sector scheme with NABARD as the national implementing agency. Right? So yes, so it is a scheme which was started into the 12th Five-Year Plan with NABARD as the national implementing institution. Right? The overall aim of the fund is to support concrete adapting activities which are not covered under ongoing activities of the state government or any central government. So here, make sure of these additional points. So this fund aims at supporting all the adaptation activities which are not been funded by any program under the union government or state government. Right? So it started in 12th Five-Year Plan. Right? So yes, it is first one is like correct statement. National Nature Campaign is an initiative of the ministry in environment education. Right? So National Nature Campaign Program is an initiative of Ministry of Environment Education, which is aimed at creating greater awareness. So here, if you take this program, this initiative is hoped that every child who goes to middle school, that is all those children who are in the classes of 6th to 8th, gets an opportunity for having an experience, a two to three day campaign experience during these years. That is, it is aimed at creating awareness and empathy among the children. It is aimed at creating empathy among children, particularly those children who are in their mid schools, that is 6th to 8th. Right? So even this is correct. Answer is both 1 and 2. Consider the following statements. India is a member of United Nations Environment Program and provides annual financial contribution of $1 lakh US to UNEP Environmental Fund. Right? Global Environment Facility, GEF, is a designated multilateral funding mechanism of 183 countries to provide incremental finance for addressing global environmental benefits. India is not a member of Global Environment Facility. So which of them is correct? So India is a member of UNEP and provides a financial contribution of 1 lakh US dollars to UNEP Environment Fund. So yes, India is a member of, right, 33 members of UNEP's International Resource Panels are currently from India. 3 of 33 members of UNEP's International Resource Panel are from India, right? So India provides an annual contribution, so it is correct. Right? India is a founding member of Global Environment Facility, right? So if you take the third statement, it is in third statement which says it is not a member, so this is wrong. Coming to second statement, it is a multilateral, it is a designated multilateral funding mechanism of 183 countries, right? The Global Environment Facility mandates is decided by the Global Environment Facility. The Global Environment Facility mandate is decided by Conference of Parties of Multilateral Environmental Conventions, namely Biological Convention, Convention on Climate Change, Convention on Combating Desertification, Stockholm Convention. So it is this Conference of Parties, right, of all these multilateral conventions, right, will decide the Global Environment Facility mandate. So please try to remember this point. Alright. So definitely we can say that GF is a designated multilateral funding mechanism of 183 countries. So second statement is correct. Now answer is 1 and 2 only. 1 and 2. 1 and 2 are the answers. Consider the following statements. So coming to 14th question. Consider the following statements about Department of Economic Affairs. It is a nodal agency of Government of India to formulate and monitor countries' economic policies as well as programs. It prepares budget for the state governments under President Rule and UTs. It monitors all the financial assistance received by India through specialized international organizations. Right? So let us go to the notes. It is a nodal agency of Government of India formulating and monitoring countries' economic policies and programs having impact on domestic and international aspects of economic management. So it is this Department of Economic Affairs, right? It is this Department of Economic Affairs which is involved in formulating as well as monitoring economic policies. If we recollect, it is this department which prepares budget. Budget is prepared by this Department of Economic Affairs, right? So statement one is correct. It is the nodal agency. It prepares budget for the state governments and UTs, particularly state governments which are under President Rule. So this is a point of doubt. The same paragraph says that it is this department which is involved in preparation and presentation of not only union budget but also budget for the state governments under President Rule and UTs, right? So the state government, right, the states which are under President Rule as well as UTs, right, their budget is prepared and presented by Department of Economic Affairs. So now it is clear that second statement is also true. Even this statement is correct. It monitors all the international financial assistance received by Government of India through specialized international organizations. Right. So other functions include formulating monitoring of economic policies, including issues relating to fiscal policy, public finance, inflation, etc. Right. All the services, it also includes all the external financial and technical assistance received by Government of India except through specialized international organizations like FAO, ILO, UNIDO, right, and except under bilateral, international bilateral specific agreements. So here, this Department of Economic Affairs, though it is involved in monitoring all the external financial technical, assistance received by Government of India, but there is an exemption. That is, it does not include the assistance received through specialized international organizations as well as assistance received under bilateral specific agreements in the fields of S&T, science and technology, culture, education. So these are the exemptions. So here there is an exemption to the work of Department of Economic Affairs. It monitors all the financial assistance received by India through specialized international organizations. So this is wrong statement. So here this is not involved. So this statement is wrong. It is an incorrect statement. So answer is 1 and 2 only. Department of Economic Affairs consists of which of them? So it is all the above. Which of the following are regarded as pillars of growth? Broadband highways, universal access to mobile connectivity, public internet access program, e-governance. Alright. So here this topic is taken from topic of communication and information technology. Right? So the nine pillars of growth are broadband highways, universal access to mobile connectivity, public internet access program, e-governance, and all the information technology related programs. Right? So answer is all the above. Which of the following are part of Digital India program? E-hospitals, Umang, telemedicine, e-Hastakshar. Right? So, telemedicine is not a part of Digital India program. Telemedicine involves space technology. It is using of satellite technology in providing medical services. So, answer is 1, 2 and 4. Sub-programs of Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan includes Bhade Bharat, Rashi Avishkar Abhiyan, Vidyanjali, Pariksha Pe Charcha. Right? So I have made notes on here. Sub-programs of Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan are Bhade Bharat, Bhade Bharat. Right? So it is a sub-program of SSA, right? Where in classes 1 and 2 is focusing on foundational learning in early grades with emphasizing on reading, writing and comprehension as well as mathematics. Right? Rashtriya Avishkar Abhiyan, right, aims at motivating and engaging children up to the age of 18 years in all science, maths and technology. Right? So schools have been adopted for mentoring by institutions of higher education like IITs, right, IISER, IISCs and NITs. So this is what a novel program of adopting schools for mentoring by IITs, IISc and NITs. So this is what about Rashtriya Avishkar Abhiyan, which is also a part of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Vidyanjali, another sub-program of SSA, was launched to enhance community participation, community and private sector involvement in government. In government run elementary schools across the country. So this is another novel program engaging community private sector, particularly in all those schools which are run by government. The aim of the program is to strengthen the implementation of co-scholastic activities in the government through services of the volunteers. Right? So this is what about Bhade Bharat, Rashtriya Avishkar Abhiyan, Vidyanjali. So these are different sub-programs of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. So Pariksha Pe Charcha is not a part of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Right? So answer is only 1, 2 and 3. Consider the following statements about Samagra Siksha. Right? So it is about Samagra Siksha. So it is implemented by Department of School Educational Literacy. It envisages school as a continuum from it envisages school as a continuum form from preschool, primary to upper primary. It is implemented in all the districts in the country. Right? So Samagra Siksha Abhiyan. The Department of School Education and Literacy launched an integrated scheme for school education from 2018. So it is a program launched by Department of School Education and Literacy, right, from 2018-19. So first statement is correct. It is implemented by Department of School Education and Literacy. It envisages school as a continuum form, right, from preschool, primary, upper primary, secondary to senior secondary levels. That is almost all the entire school education as and plus two education is covered under this Samagra Siksha Abhiyan. So not only preschool, primary school to upper primary school, but even it also includes secondary and senior secondary levels. So it is not restricted only to upper primary. So this is the wrong one. It is implemented in all the districts in the country. Now if you take the statement, this program is implemented, preference is being given to educationally backward blocks, special focus on districts, border areas, special focal districts, border areas and aspirational districts identified by Niti Aayog. So there is a selection of schools particularly from educationally backward blocks, special focus districts, border areas and all the aspirational districts identified by Niti Aayog. Alright. So it is implemented in all the districts of the country, right? So it is not implemented in all the districts, it is implemented only in certain districts. So answer is only one. Right. So as we don't find answer here, so answer, let it change this answer into only one. It is only one which is true. Which of the following are true? So second is wrong and third is wrong. It is only one which is correct. So I beg your pardon for this mistake. The scheme of Kendriya, coming to 20th question, the scheme of Kendriya Vidyalaya was approved in 1962 to provide uninterrupted education to the wards of transferable central and state government employees. Navodaya Vidyalayas to provide good quality modern education to the talented children predominantly from rural areas without regard to their family's socio-economic conditions. Which of the above is true? Right? So let us see. The scheme of Kendriya Vidyalaya was approved in 1962 to provide uninterrupted education to the wards of transferable central government employees. Right? Transferable central government employees. So that means there is no state government employees in this. First statement is wrong. So it is only for employees of union government. Right? Navodaya, the National Education Policy of 1986, right, established residential Navodaya schools with an aim of providing excellence coupled with equity and justice. So this is what the objective of Navodaya schools, right? Providing excellence coupled with equity and social justice. Consequently, Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti was registered as a society. Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti is a registered society under Registration Act of 1860. Right? So, the purpose of this Vidyalayas is to provide good quality modern education, right? Predominantly from rural areas without regard to their family socio-economic conditions. That is, for all the children, for all the birds from rural areas. So Navodaya Vidyalaya to provide good quality modern education to talented children predominantly from rural areas without regard to their family socio-economic conditions. So first is wrong and second one is correct. National Bal Bhavan. Had question on National Bal Bhavan. It is established in 1956. It is an autonomous institution funded by Ministry of Human Resources and Development. It aims at enhancing creative potential for the children. Alright, so it is established in 1956. It is established in 1956. It is an autonomous institution funded by Ministry of Human Resources Development. It is a movement spread right among in the entire country. Right, it aims at enhancing creative potential of the children by providing them various activities, opportunities, and common platforms to interact. Right, so all the above are correct. So first is wrong, correct. So answer is all the. Coming to 22nd question. Which of the following programs aims at increasing academic exposure for Northeastern students? Ishan Vikas, Ishan Uday, Saksham, Pragati. Saksham is a program which is aimed for differently abled children. So it is not for Northeast students. So it is not the right one. Ishan Uday, it is for Northeast students, Northeast region, students of Northeast region. So it is even. Is not correct. Pragati is a academic exposure for Pragati is a program aimed at increasing advancement of girls' participation in the technical education. So Pragati, it is for increasing girls' participation in technical education. So it is Ishan Vikas. It is Ishan Vikas which increases academic exposure. So this is what the answer. Which of the following aims to achieve universal household electrification in the country? Deen Dayal Upadhyay Gram Jyoti Yojana, Uday, Saubhagya, Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. So let us talk about all these programs. Deen Dayal Upadhyay Gram Jyoti Yojana. The objectives of this program are to separate agriculture and non-agriculture feeders, strengthening and augmenting substations or sub-transmission and distribution infrastructure, meeting the rural areas, right? Metering of rural areas. All right. So this is what about Deen Dayal Upadhyay Gram Jyoti Yojana. So it is simply about strengthening the transmission and distribution infrastructure in the rural areas. Right. So it is not an universal household electrification program. It is only infrastructure strengthening program. So Uday scheme, which was launched in 2015, right, for a sustainable solution for operational and financial efficient Uday scheme was launched in 2015 for a sustainable solution to the operational and financial inefficiencies of DISCOMs across the country. Right, so here the purpose of this Uday scheme, the purpose of Uday scheme is to increase the operational and financial efficiencies of distributing companies. Right? And so even this is not the answer. Saubhagya. Right? To achieve universal household electrification in the country by March 2019. Right? It is a universal household electrification program. Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana. Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana. So it is a universal household electrification program which was started in March 2019. Right. So in order to provide clean cooking fuel to poor households, especially in rural areas. Right. Coming to Pradhan Mantri Ujjwal Yojana. The purpose of this program is to provide free LPG connections. So Ujjwal Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Ujjwal Yojana aims at providing free LPG connections to the women belonging. So here if you take this beneficiary component, it is to the women belonging to the below poverty line. So women of BPL families, right, they are been given free LPG connections under this Pradhan Mantri Ujjwal Yojana. Right. So this is not the answer. So answer is Saubhagya. Saubhagya is a universal household electrification program in the country. Consider the following statements. Sahaj was a digital initiative launched by oil marketing companies for lease of LPG connections with online payment. And it is a digital initiative launched by oil marketing companies for release of LPG connections with online payment. Pahal initiative is aimed at rationalizing subsidies. Let us see. So if take this Pahal, Pahal is a measure of good governance introduced, right, well targeted system of subsidies delivered to the LPG program. So it aims at a rationalizing subsidies based approach to cut the leakages, right, to cut the subsidy leakages. Right. So Pahal is a measure of good governance. The purpose is to ensure targeted subsidy delivery to the LPG consumers. So and to avoid the wastage of subsidies and to avoid leakages of subsidy. Right. So it is aimed at, Pahal is an initiative aimed at rationalizing subsidy based approach. So it is correct. Coming to Sahaj. Sahaj is a digital initiative launched by oil marketing companies for release of LPG connections with online payment and issue of, right. So this is what about Sahaj. So Sahaj is a digital initiative where the purpose is to release LPG connections with online payment. So answer is both 1 and 2. Coming to the 25th question, consider the following statements. The development of solar cities programs aims at minimizing 10% reduction in projected demand of conventional energy at the end of 10 years. Right? The development of, once again I read the statement, the development of solar cities programs aims at minimum 10% reduction in projected demand of conventional energy at the end of 10 years. Right. Coming to second statement, National Solar Mission was the first mission to be operationalized under National Action Plan on Climate Change. Right. So the first statement is on solar cities. Let me talk about the solar cities. The development of solar cities program aims at minimum 10% reduction in projected demand of conventional energy at the end of 5 years. So 10% reduction in the demand, 10% reduction in the demand of conventional energy within a period of 5 years. So these are three points to be remembered for solar city program. These are 3 points which are to be remembered for solar city program. Reduction of demand of conventional energy, right, to a minimum of 10% by the end of 5 years. So it is given as 10 years. So this is wrong. National Solar Mission was the first mission to be operationalized under National Action Plan for Climate Change. So if you take this National Solar Mission is the first mission operationalized under National Action Plan on Climate Change. So it is a three-phase approach. Right? Where the objective is to establish India as a global leader in solar energy. Right? So, yes, second one is correct. So, answer is only 2, which is correct. Right? So, this is what about part 1 of a 4-part series. I hope you have understood the topic. You are clear with the questions as well as answers. And I hope all my students to look into this video. look into the video where the exam was conducted earlier.